Rachel, thank you. We continue to reflect on the tragedy that changed Oklahoma City forever. And let's head out back to my co-anchor, Anita. On this 17th anniversary, we're hearing from one of the first responders.
That's right, Matt. You know, it was an emotional time for Oklahoma City, for everyone. In fact, I was just checking the live wire here on my cell phone, and Angie wrote that she was at home when she got a call shortly after 9 from her mom. Her mom saw smoke coming from the building where her dad worked, and it was almost an hour before they were able to get back in contact with him to find out that he was fine. But she says she will never forget, and none of us will, especially the first responders. They came right down here to a pile of rubble. And for Rockie Yardley, he says that it was especially draining. You know, he is an Edmond police officer, and in the midst of the chaos and confusion, Yardley decided to write a message. Little did he know it would be captured forever. It made newspapers around the world. It's even in our history books. We asked him how he came up with those words on the old Journal Record building, and here's what he had to say.
It came to me one night, and I asked permission to put it on the wall. I never thought, I just assumed they would tear that building down or paint over it. And since then, I've painted over it twice to because it's starting to fade. But they want to keep it on there, so as long as I'm around, I'll keep painting it back.
Yeah, you may also remember the image of Yardley reuniting with his son, Max. They didn't get to see each other much in the weeks after the bombing. And what you're looking at right now here on the screen, if you will come back out live here to us, is the image that he wrote right there. It's from team number 5, and on it you can see the date. 4/19/1995. That image was used in a Garth Brooks video that was saluting first responders that did so much to get our city back to some semblance of normalcy and to try to save as many lives as they could. For that, we'll all be forever grateful. Matt, we'll talk more about what's going to be happening here to honor our first responders and, of course, remember the lives lost in a few moments.